Hello, my name is Dr. Jean Gariépy, a professor at the University of Toronto and a senior scientist at the Sunnybrook Research Institute. In this JCI Insight paper, we report the discovery of a linkage between the residual transcriptional activity of mutant p53 and cancer outcome in patients. I'm happy to provide a brief overview of our recent publication on the diverse effect of different p53 mutations on cancer survival. P53 is a well-known tumor suppressor protein that acts as a critical barrier to cancer. As such, it has been named the guardian of the genome. The P53 gene is the most frequently mutated gene in cancer that occurs in over 50% of all tumors. Hundreds of different P53 mutations occur across the entire gene, and emerging evidence suggests that not all of these mutations are equally deleterious. Some P53 mutants are completely inactive, while others retain nearly all normal activity. We focused our study on missense mutations that account for the majority of P53 mutations and identified 2,314 cancer patients with 403 unique mutations. In order to understand the clinical implication of this functional diversity, we performed a meta-analysis that integrated mutation-specific functional information with patient data. The functional information that we used was obtained from the work of Cato and colleagues, who reported the transcriptional activity of P53 mutant at 8 different P53 DNA response elements using a yeast-based reporter assay. We calculated the median transcriptional activity value across these 8 DNA reporter elements for each P53 mutant. Next, we assigned a score to the individual patient that we identify with a P53 mutation according to its residual transcriptional activity and placed them into bins. We then performed a pan-cancer analysis and identified a strong association between increased mutant P53 residual transcriptional activity and improved survival for glioma and gastric adenocarcinoma patients. Unexpectedly, this association was male-specific, as it was not observed among females with any cancer type under investigation. P53 mutations are also the underlying cause of a hereditary cancer predisposition disorder called Li-Fraumeni syndrome. These individuals carry germline P53 mutation, which means that P53 mutations are present in every cell of their body. As a result, they are predisposed to developing multi-organ cancer throughout their lifetime. The link between mutant P53 residual transcriptional activity with survival was recapitulated in our data set of 1,049 individuals with germline P53 mutation, in which we identified 188 unique mutations. We found that increased residual transcriptional activity was clearly associated with longer lifetime survival, as well as delayed tumor onset. The male-specific association was reflected by the finding that males with germline P53 mutation were significantly more likely to develop brain and gastric cancers.
To explain our findings, we like to use the analogy of a cell phone. Even if there's only 5% battery life left, it remains functional, and you can dial 911 in case of an emergency. However, when the battery runs out, all of its functions disappear. In this analogy, P53 would respond to a 911 call for an emergency such as DNA damage caused by a carcinogen or sun exposure.
In our paper, we provide a prognostic guide that divides all clinically observed P53 mutations into low, intermediate, and high-risk groups. As P53 mutations are commonly tested in a panel of frequently mutated genes in cancer, stratifying patients based on the transcriptional score of their individual P53 mutations is directly translatable to the clinic, where it can be considered to aid counseling and clinical decision-making. For example, male glioma patients with transcriptionally inactive p53 mutants, such as R248Q, might be considered for more aggressive treatment strategies. For individuals with Li-Fraumeni syndrome carrying germline p53 mutations, those with lower transcriptional activity mutants could begin cancer screening programs earlier, while those with mutants that retain nearly all transcriptional activity could defer the financial, physical, and emotional costs of invasive screening tests until later in life.
Overall, we hope that our study will provide an updated and refined interpretation of p53 mutations in cancer that will help to guide treatment decisions and the stratification of patients in future clinical trials.